Okay, today we're just having a look at a few of the new features in MODO 701, Luxology's latest version in animation, 3D animation package. So there's a few things I wanted to review just within the items and shader lists that are small but very useful enhancements. So first one is coloring items in the shader tree. I've just got a simple scene here with several objects and some materials set to those so that you can see a shader tree already set up. Just a light blue, a black, and a red material. And what you can do with this now is you can edit with the right click and apply a color for any of your items in here. And so unfortunately there's no black or dark color, so we could leave that one alone, and then on red, you know, we could color that. So you can use these to organize your scene, your grouping, your material types, you know, different ways to organize it. It's very handy to have that in the system. And of course you can edit and turn those back off again as well. So a very simple but handy feature, being able to color items in the shader tree. You can also apply that to your items list. So you could select a group of items that you want to keep organized, and you can apply a color to those. And it's just a convenient way of helping to keep things organized. The next feature just to highlight is in the shader tree. What you can do now as well, you can right click on a material group and you can lock that preset. And so what that will do with the lock icon here, just as an indicator, it'll allow you to tack that material in place on those surfaces and prevent you from being able to edit those surfaces. So the preset will stay locked onto that surface, and so that's a handy feature, helps to prevent edits when you want to make sure that that stays attached. And of course, you can right click to unlock. Okay, one more simple feature, but a very handy one as well in the shader tree, is I've got three objects here, and this is a simple scene, so the shader tree is very simple to look at, but a huge scene, a complex scene, can have literally hundreds of materials, material groups, shader masks, and pages of elements within the shader tree. So it can be very difficult sometimes to find the shaded elements of interest. This new feature under the filter menu, filter by selection, which you can also use by turning on the shortcut here with this little S feature, will filter the shader tree selection based on what objects you have selected. So you can see I've selected this, and all there is the default and the black. If I select this one, it's the default and the light blue. If I select this one, default and the red, those are my colors. And of course it applies across multi-selects as well. So if I have each of these selected, you can see what it's going to show for each that is selected. Very handy feature to be able to filter by selection. Okay, and last I want to show another new feature. This is a great addition to helping you organize your content and your shader tree. There's a new element here within the shader tree called library, and what you can do with that is you can create library materials that then get referenced, similar to instancing, but everything's linked back to one item within your library. So let's just, on this light blue material up here, let's just add an image. And I'm going to just use one from my clip browser that I've just loaded, tire tread. And I'm going to show that on to the object, and that's simple. And you could now put the, if I wanted to put that on these other two objects, typically you'd have to copy that into those materials. And what this new library system does is gives us a better way to manage that. And so I'm going to just highlight this tire tread and create a group out of it using Control G. And I can give it a name now, where I call this my tire image. And then this tire image I'm going to put into my library. And you're going to see what Modo does as soon as I drop it in there is create a reference to the tire image, or it moves the material into the library, and the reference is left behind right here. So now in order to add that to the other two materials here as well, I can simply drag and drop it onto the material from the library, and for each of those references now they all link back to this same tire image. So the big advantage of this is I can come now to a single tire reference, and I can make additions to that. So here I'm just going to extend UV mapping. You can see it applies to all three simultaneously because they're referenced. I can also rename these, so I could say, well, this is not just a tire image, but this is a tire tread image. And that reference name will be used throughout them all. So a great way to add referencing and help manage some of the material content in MODO 701. Hope you enjoyed this and enjoy the rest of the features in 701.